I got a little too much on there. Yeah, I definitely got too much on there.
Hey, it's Pete. Welcome back to my workshop. This week, I'm actually going to start putting pieces back onto the milling machine. And with any luck at all, we're going to get to see all three axes move. Hey, before we get started this week, I'd just like to ask, if you're not already subscribing to this channel, please consider clicking that subscribe button. It really does help the channel out.
So I have to admit, this part of the project has gotten a little bit out of hand. Now, this bracket is at the rear of the Y-axis. It holds the ball screw here. It just prevents the screw from whipping as it's moving. So that's going to mount at the rear of the Y-axis. It also helps to guard it so chips don't get under it and things. I decided to, I was going to just degrease this thing. And after degreasing it, I decided, well, let's dump it in the Evapo-Rust and see what happens. Now, Evapo-Rust is something I haven't used before. I picked up a bottle of it because I've got another project coming up where I'm going to be doing a restoration of a old Enco hex turret tailstock for my Clausen Colchester lathe, and I'm going to probably be needing it there. So I figured I'd dunk this part just to get a feel for how it works. And of course, it took off a lot of the bluing. But one thing it revealed was it looks like there was actually a repair in the manufacturing process. I have to figure this happened during manufacturing because, you know, if somebody just dented their plate on their milling machine, they wouldn't have even bothered probably fixing it. It doesn't actually affect the part in any way. It just looks like something dug in and took a notch out of there, and they went and filled it and then remachined it. Or maybe even they welded a hole shut in the plate before they ever cut this piece. I don't know, but it's kind of interesting that that's even there at all. So I guess the next thing I'm going to do is probably heat this part up and apply some cold bluing, and we'll see how that comes out.
All right, we just put this in the oven just to get it a little warm. I'm going to try this bluing compound now. I got a little too much on there. Yeah, I definitely got too much on there. But it seems to be doing a decent job. And reality here, this is the surface I should be focusing on because this is what is seen. This is what faces up. Definitely see that area where the repair was covers a little bit differently. All right, well, let's clean this up a little bit here. All right, I'm going to work on trying to get some of this stuff back together here in the rear of the machine. I'm at the back of the Y-axis now, and I got a few things to put back on. First of all, I've got this way wiper to put in. Now, this is just a little piece of rubber with a metal insert. Acts as a way wiper. It also covers access to the gib adjusting screw, so I may have to get back in there and revisit this. But for the time being, I'd just like to get it back together. This block holds the way wiper in place, and then it has two set screws that you use to actually push the way wiper against the back of the ways. So just a little adjustment screw here and here. So we got that back in. The other thing I want to do now is put this rear cover on. So this is a bushing right here that it traps the end of the lead screw, and it prevents the lead screw from whipping. It's not really a bearing. It's not even a bushing, actually. It's just a metal sleeve, and that's held in place by this bracket here, which we cleaned up. So I'm going to put this in place. And then find the end of the lead screw. And we'll start putting these in. Actually, I'm pretty pleased with how that came out. I don't think that looks too bad at all, especially for a part that's on the back of the Y-axis that you're never going to see once this this is an accordion piece that goes in here to cover the ways. And once that's in there, you're never going to see this piece. So like I said before, it was a little bit little overkill on what I went through to that piece, but primarily I just wanted to work with the different materials and see exactly what kind of result we got. So after I did the bluing on this, I wiped it down with steel wool, and then I wiped it down with oil. All right. I think that'll do. All right, after learning what we learned about the Y-axis, I'm a little bit curious about the Z-axis, so I went and I pulled that out. And just going to see how these look in here, because I know that the Z-axis was somewhat disturbed. I know that it was run without the counterweight, stripped the teeth off the drive belt for the Z-axis. So we'll have a look, see what there is to see. Let's see what we've got. We got one. All right, so I'm gonna go through this and see what we've got. Enough room to get my wrench in there. Thank you.
So I went and I did some tweaking in the parameters for the Z-axis and the X-axis. The X-axis is actually really good, as I anticipated it would be. Still some tweaking that can be done to improve it, but for the time being, we're in the ballpark. I can always work on that some more down the road. As a matter of fact, I don't even think the GIB is installed in the Z-axis right now, so there's some more things to be done there.
100 at a time.
So where do we go from here? Well, lots of little things need to be done yet. Right now, everything is just sort of precariously balanced here with all the wires hooked up, and we need to start buttoning it back up. Still need to figure out what I'm going to do with the spindle motor and the drive for that. Probably for the time being, I'm just going to hook it back up the same way it was in the original Dyna Myte system, just to get the thing up and running. And as we go on down the road here, hopefully we can come up with a better solution for that. There's a few pieces that are missing. I'm missing the guard for the back of the spindle counterbalance back here. That was something that was missing when I received the machine. I'm also missing one of these cover boxes that cover the stepper motors. So I need to figure out something to do about that. There's some other guarding missing, and of course the whole chip tray and everything that was originally supposed to be with this machine, that's also missing. We didn't have that. It is drilled for it though, so I believe that it did used to exist. It wasn't like a stripped model that was purchased without those. So lots of little things to do, but you know, I'm encouraged because the whole machine is up and running. Well, that's about it for this week, and as always, please like, share, subscribe, comment down below, and I'll catch you next week.